In this video, you're going to discover four things that you and your team should never say to a dental patient. Inadvertently saying these things is turning off prospective new patients on the phone, it's hurting your case acceptance, you can even offend existing patients. Ultimately, it's costing you money. I'm going to share four gems, and we're starting right now.
And now, Amazon number one best-selling author, Dr. Tom "The Gems Guy" Orent.
Greetings from Planet Gems. I'm Dr. Tom Orent, aka The Gems Guy. 20 years ago, I was $1 million in debt, divorced by my wife, I was being embezzled. I came within 3 days of bankruptcy. I was a good dentist, but I was clueless when it came to the business part. Almost lost my practice and my home, and then I stumbled across a gem, and then another, and they actually began to help. So I began actively searching for gems, strategies to help me rebuild my practice and my life. At age 46, I was able to retire. Since then, my passion has been helping other dentists create more opportunities to do more of your best dentistry, have more fun, and make a lot more money. If you're a general dentist and you want to avoid saying things that can hurt your relationship with your patients, decrease your case acceptance, and ultimately cost you money, then you're in the right place. Gem number four, the one question never to ask a caller on the phone. Mrs. Jones, it would be my pleasure to help you set up an appointment. Are you a new patient? If Mrs. Jones has been with your practice for 12 years and she just hasn't been in for a while, maybe it's been a year or more and you didn't recognize her name, you couldn't find her real quickly in the computer, you risk hurting your relationship with her by asking her if she's new to your practice. If you don't recognize the name and you can't quickly find her in the computer, there's a simple fix. Mrs. Jones, it would be my pleasure to help you schedule an appointment. Tell me, roughly when was the last time you were in the practice? Now, if she's brand new, she's going to tell you that right then and there. If she's an existing patient, she's going to give you her best guess about the last time she was in. The date that she gives you, not important. The fact that she gave you a rough estimate means that you need to look more carefully into the computer. You're going to find her. Just don't ever ask a caller, are you a new patient? GEMS members, you may recognize this one. It was number 12 in my 24 things never to say to a dental patient. If you're finding this helpful, I'd really appreciate if you could click like and share this with other dentists. If you're a general dentist and you're finding this helpful, join our community of dentists around the world sharing GEMS to improve patient care, have more fun, and make more money. We'd welcome you to join our free Facebook group, Dental Goldmine Mastermind. There's a link in the description below. Gem number three, a single word substitution during exam and case presentation instantly improves comprehension and acceptance. I discovered this gem from a dental assistant in the office of one of our Gems Platinum family in Hawaii. She says, Dr. Orent, we have a gem for you. Sometimes after we tell a patient that they have decay under an old filling, we assume they understood, but then at the end of the visit, they look at us and they say, hey, but do I have any cavities? She went on to say that they substituted a single word and have had far better patient comprehension as a result. Instead of using the word decay, they replaced it with the word cavity. For example, Mrs. Smith, you have a new cavity under your old filling. In my two practices, we had 5 hygienists. Once they replaced decay with new cavity, they unanimously told me that they'd never go back. This gem became number 4 of my 24 things never to say to a dental patient. Don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss a thing and hit the bell notification so YouTube will let you know when I release my next video. Would you like to protect your adult patients against cervical caries by getting 80% acceptance of adult fluoride paid willingly out of pocket? With just 7 simple sentences, you'll add $40,000 per year per hygienist. That's $200,000 pure profit over the next 5 years. How could that change your lifestyle? Done for you in just 30 minutes. Take advantage of our free one-on-one 7 simple sentences fluoride verbal skills training for doctor and team. To get your free live training, go to gemsscripts.com/2. There's a link in the description below. Gem number 2. One word spoken by a nurse caused my mother to leave her new primary care physician. So what was that word? It was her first name, Daisy. A 20-year-old medical assistant comes out to the reception area and she says to my 80-year-old mother, you must be Daisy. My mother was far too reserved to say anything to the assistant or to the doctor. She simply never went back. Now, would you or I react like that? Probably not. But how we feel about someone younger than we are calling us by our first name without ever having been invited to do so, that's irrelevant. The only thing that matters is there are people out there who do care. Oh, and tell your team not to ask permission. May I call you Daisy is almost as bad, but there's a simple fix. Unless your new patient is significantly younger than your team member, she should call her by her last name unless she's invited to do otherwise. This gem is number 19 of my 24 things never to say to a dental patient. Do you have a favorite phrase that you've banned from use in your practice? If so, please share it with us in the comments below. If you're finding this helpful, you'll really like the in-depth team training, 24 things never to say to a dental patient. If you're a GEMS Family Platinum, your personal GEMS concierge will show you where to find it. But even if you're not a member, I'm happy to share it with you for free. Take a free 6-week test drive of GEMS Platinum. During your first 6 weeks, deploy even one GEM and you could increase $40,000 increased annual revenue. GEMS are fun, they won't take much of your time, and they're really easy. 6 weeks free, you pay just $6 one-time shipping fee, and they're so easy, I'm offering you a 10 times money back satisfaction guarantee. All I ask, speak with your personal GEMS concierge together, choose just one easy GEM to deploy during your 6-week free test drive. If for any reason you're not satisfied with the GEMS during your 6-week free test drive, just let me know and I'll refund $60. That's 10 times your $6 one-time shipping fee. To get your 6-week free test drive of GEMS Platinum, go to gemsyoutube.com. There's a link in the description below. Gem number one, the word used daily by doctors and team members, which could cost you thousands of dollars in courtesy remakes down the road and endless aggravation. The word is permanent, used when referring to placing a crown. Mrs. Jones, be careful not to bite into anything sticky with your temporary crown. Your permanent crown will be back from the lab next week. Of course, eliminating the word permanent when referring to crowns and cement, that won't guarantee you'll never have a patient expecting that you're going to replace some 15-year-old failed crown for free. But routinely using the word permanent is bound to cause problems, and it's easy to solve. Instead of permanent crown, just substitute the material instead. So for example, Mrs. Jones, Nancy's going to schedule your visit to cement the porcelain crown when it comes back from the lab. This was number 3 of my 24 things never to say to a dental patient. Dr. Pete Dawson wrote the foreword to my first book, and Dr. Gordon Christensen wrote the foreword to my fourth book, Transform Your Practice from Coal Mine to Gold Mine. It's on Amazon for $16.97, but I'm happy to send it to you for free as my thanks for being with me here in the Dental Goldmine. I'll even cover the shipping. Two gems in the book could increase your revenue by $50,000 a year. While available, claim your free book at freegemsbook.com. There's a link in the description below. Hey, thanks for joining me here in the Dental Goldmine, and remember, you're only one gem away.